Hey guys, this is Noisy, and today I'm going to be playing Crash Time. Continuing where I left off, I'm going to be doing Old Friends. I have completed the previous case in Hard, and man, it was torture.
Hey Chris, how about calling it a day?
Sounds good. I wanted to visit an old friend. You think you could drop me off there? I'm not going to be able to drive tonight anyway.
Okay, we just need to fill up on gas.
In the gas station.
That was close. I almost ended up having to take you to your buddy on foot.
Good timing. My friend's just getting home. They're taking him to the hospital. The doctor says he's gonna make it.
Your friend was lucky. I've been taking a look around. Looks like his car drove over a mine.
A mine? You mean someone was trying to kill him?
Yeah, maybe the guy in the car across the street. He's been watching us the whole time.
Maybe it's just the press following the police cars?
I can't say for sure, but I think he was already parked there when we arrived.
He's starting the engine. If you're right, we should follow him.
All right, this is time to shadow. He's drawing a Fiat. Oh, shoot.
This was just supposed to be a fun evening.
A train.
I can't imagine why anyone would want to kill my friend.
How did you guys meet?
We went to the police academy together. But he got a sports injury and ended up working in the lab.
So you could say he's a colleague with a long list of criminals convicted in the past.
You're right. That's a lot of suspects.
Oh, that was a close call. I just hit a van and then he just got the upper hand.
Chris, what's up? Do you know the victim?
He was also a friend of mine. I just didn't know he lived here.
When was the last time you saw him?
At the police academy reunion, 2 weeks ago.
He went to the academy too?
Yes.
Do you think the bastard could be after all of you?
Could be. Where's the guy we were shadowing?
He hit the road when we got out.
Then we better find him, and fast.
I think we should warn all your other classmates from the academy before anyone else gets hurt. Have you got a list?
At home, yes.
Then let's go and get it.
Okay, now we gotta get to Chris's house. I don't even think it's the quarry. Okay, time is ticking. We don't have that much time left. Okay. And we made it. Just on time.
Have you got the list?
Yes, I'm just faxing it to the precinct.
We'll get Suzanne to try and contact the guys.
I'll just move my car, and then we can head over to the precinct.
Chris, no, don't touch that car! Chris, Chris, damn it, you just activated a bomb under your car.
We can't let it go up here. Is there a display? Can you see a countdown?
A display, yes, but no countdown. Damn, I can't tell. What are you doing?
I'm gonna take the car somewhere where it can explode without anyone getting hurt.
You're crazy!
Well, Chris is trying to take an arrow through his own hand. Oh shoot, I remember the button I can use to exit the vehicle, just like how I did in Nitro. So I must do it in the right time. Sorry, in a rush. Ah, shoot. So I must be in a specific speed.
Them and the chief has dispatched security teams.
Great. Let's hope no one else gets blown up now.
Forensics called earlier. They've asked me to tell you that the mines they found at the crime scenes were probably army issue.
Thanks, Suzanne.
Let's go and ask Camouflage and Co. if they're missing any mines.
All right. Now we're going to go see the military. We're going to a military base. And see whoever made the mine.
Thank you.
was a bit too fast, but it didn't matter, because I had to get to the place on time. And right on time.
Hello, we're from the Auto Patrol. We're investigating two assassination attempts involving mines. Our lab analysts have found evidence indicating that these mines were taken from your arsenal.
That can't be, really. Our ammo is always counted and checked. We keep very tight records.
So if any mines went missing, you ought to notice.
And not everyone has access to storage, right?
That is both correct. However, I suggest I have the records checked for you and send you a report, including a list of people who have access to the ammunition storage.
That'd be great.
Semir, Chris, we just got an emergency call. The fireman, one of your old classmates, is on his way in his ambulance.
Which means he's activated another bomb.
Yeah, Hartman says if it's the same kind of bomb that was in your car, it'll blow up if he doesn't maintain a minimum speed.
Tell him to switch on his light and the siren. We're gonna try and catch up with him.
And then?
He changes cars.
Alright, now we have to go today for someone. Oh, I was in the wrong direction. Let me try again.
Semir, Chris.
Get close.
Hey, Chris, thanks. Whew, that was real close.
You're welcome.
Man, I need some coffee.
Don't worry. You can have a cup at our office.
I saved him on the nick of time.
Wow, that's fast. The army's sending someone with a report.
The report is already here. Came in a few minutes ago on the fax, and I put it on your desk.
What is that army jeep doing here, then?
What jeep?
Look outside, man.
That car was behind us on the way here.
Isn't that the guy we were chasing after the first attack?
Could be. So let's go and talk to him.
In that case, we better hurry. He's leaving right now.
We better choose something all-terrain, too.
And it looks like we have to use an all-terrain vehicle as well.
Thank you.
sec. Alright, I'm back.
Still doesn't want to talk to us.
Damn! Ever driven a tank?
It's been a while.
No bull. You actually have driven a tank?
When I was 9. At Legoland.
You've driven a You drove a tank when you were 9 years old and when you were in Legoland. Interesting. Memory was kind of rusty at the time. I remember being in a Hercules plane, if I recall. A C-47 Globemaster. Not to mention there was like the Blue Angel there. Thank you.
Chris. Following him in a tank is absolutely useless.
And he's a better driver, too.
Haven't we still got that drone with the explosives underneath our car?
Great idea. So let's get to cracking that armor.
And we're going on another vehicle. Because that tank is not fast enough. Oh, shoot. It just froze for a split sec. But it doesn't matter. Let's continue. Alright, alright, so second tank. Don't think you can get away with this so easy. Because I'm gonna break your armor. This tank is no more.
What a mess. Chris, Semir, what possessed you to follow a tank and reduce half the city to rubble in the process?
Boss, the suspect is responsible for 4 terrorist attacks. He almost got Chris. We couldn't let him get away.
And why would this man want to eliminate all former members of the police academy?
He's a former member himself. Even one of the best of his year. But as a cadet, he often grew violent during arrests, roughed up quite a few suspects. So we had to pack up and leave. And then he joined the army.
He never really got over being kicked out of the police force. And hearing the active police officers talk at the reunion probably blew his fuse.
He felt he was being treated unfairly and singled out, so he wanted to pay back his former comrades at the academy.
Oh yeah, here's the medal of the previous case I did in hard. So now it turns out that suspect had snapped when he saw his former colleague. But anyway, this is the end of the video. I'll continue to wait here in the next part. But anyway, thanks for watching and take care.